All right, it is very, very sad, a very sad evening. As you can see, this is the this is the hearse that is waiting to carry Fred Omondi home. As you can see, the body has just touched down Kisumu, and we are waiting for the body to come out so that we can take him home in Sega. There was a flight delay. The body was supposed to touch down at 6:30 p.m. But due to the flight delays, the body has touched down a bit late. It has just touched down. And as you can see, the preparation is underway. The convoy is here. As you can see, the hearse is here, ready to take Fred Omondi home. As you can see, in loving memory of Fred Odhiambo Omondi, as we are live from Kisumu International Airport, and right now we are waiting. The convoy is here.
Check it. Badilisha.
This is a whole convoy of vehicles awaiting to take Fred Omondi home for the last time from Kisumu International Airport. And the body is being cleared at the airport reception so that we can have the body being brought to this hearse that we have just seen here so that it can be taken home. So from wherever you are, we shall be streaming live to give you all the updates of this particular convoy from the starting point when we receive the body from the airport authorities to the time that the body will reach home. So it is a very, very sad evening. A lot is going on. People are so emotional. Because it is unfortunate that the last time, 2 days to Fred's death, he left Kisumu and he left through this very international airport, as you can see. So it is very unfortunate that 2 days to Fred Omondi's death, that is on Thursday, Fred Omondi had an event in Kisumu and he left on Friday through this very airport as a passenger. And the following day he died, and today he is coming through the same airport as a cargo. It is a very sad evening. As you can see, a lot is going on. So many people are here. From the other hand, those are all convoys. That is a convoy that is waiting to take Fred Omondi home. This side we have so many people here, and from wherever you are, if you can see, so many people are here. Tuko na watu ambao pia wako na mahitaji tofauti tofauti.
Mimi nataka mama.
Kwanza unaitwa nani?
Mimi jina langu wananiita Shims Media. Lakini jina la kitanii wananiita MC Gogo.
MC Gogo.
Watu sema mimi ni look alike kwa yule DJ anaitwa MC Gogo. Si wengi mnamjua. So wengi wao wana confuse.
Na sasa kwa nini unataka mama?
Mama nina mahitaji. msichana rika yangu ana pesa za kunipa. Mimi nataka pesa bwana. So niko hapa kuagiza
sio. Nataka mbaba.
Mbaba anifanyie nini?
Asaidie mama yako kukulisha.
Anitoanishe wewe. Ni mama tu.
Asaidie mama yako kukulisha.
Ah, okay. All right. All right. Yes. Tuko na teacher Kalausi.
Yes, Tiaria. Uh-huh. One and only teacher Kalausi. Uh-huh. My question to these people wenye wanasemanga, oh, mimi sikunywi chai ya maziwa, sikunywi chai ya maziwa. Uh-huh. Niwaulize, mkiwa wadogo mlikuwa mnanyonya mzinga? That's a simple question. Nawachanayo, kitaneni tena pale mtandaoni.
Yes.
I go by the name TR Kalausi.
Yes.
Nipples, so these are nipples ni za nini? Batmark.
Batman.
Hii inadhihirisha kwamba nimezaliwa na mamangu.
Hapana, unajua watu wako na dimples ni people with disabilities.
That's what you think. That's what you think.
Disability ile tuko nayo ni kwamba we are handsome, we have the money.
Exactly.
Wenye wana dimples wanatafuta wa mama.
Tuko tuko hapa na Le Grand Engineer Wood Phoebe. Good evening, engineer. Karibu sana. We are here actually to receive Fred Omondi. And what can you say about Fred Omondi, your moments together, and maybe one last thing you can just say about Fred?
Fred Omondi was my great friend. And vile nilisema awali in some interview ya kwamba Fred nikiwa Nairobi yeye ndiye alinifundisha all the clubs I know in Nairobi, all the good clubs, mali watu wako na pesa kama mimi wanaweza enda. And so him losing his life vile ali lose, vile I said, I feel vibaya. At times I feel it is my fault. Kwa sababu hiyo Friday we were to go out with my daughter Mani.
Yeah.
And we were like, where do we go out? So I was like, wacha nipigie Fred, nijue ako wapi tuende. So that we can hang out together, because ndio mimi hang out na yeye. Then apparently one of Amani's friend akasema kuna club flani flani, so I had to take her there. And tuka hang out mpaka around 6 a.m. And then hiyo 6 a.m.
Yeah.
Apparently Fred was coming actually ile route tulikuwa Kamundo road, Kwiba, Islands, you know? So after that I went back to my place in Kileleshwa. Na nikiingia tu kwa nyumba, a friend of mine calls me, nasikia Fred amekufa wapi ati Kamundo road. So I quickly called Eric Omondi, akanambia ako kwa barabara anaenda hivyo, ajui what has happened. So I can follow him. Nikatoa gari tukio kwa nyumba, quickly nikampigia akanambia ako mama Lucy kuingia pale napata Freddy is in the morgue. So it was a sad moment. And I felt like ningempigia tungekutana na yeye from there tungeenda somewhere else, maybe using my car. Unaona, but because alikuwa na rush mahali alitumia boda. So that's why I've been so emotional about this thing. But again, we cannot question the will of God. At times things happen, they happen, things we may not know why it happened. But God anajua kila kitu. Nothing happens in the surface of the world without his knowledge. So all we are left to do is just to celebrate his life, and you know, remember him for the good things and the good times we share together. But above all, we mourn together with his friends, family. And Fred Omondi was a kind of a state figure, let me say so. You know, because he made all of us laugh, from the president to the least. You get the point? From people in the leafy suburbs of the great towns in Kenya, to the people in low life, middle age, whatever. But what I can say, he was a great person, we loved him, and because of his greatness, that's why we are all gathered here now. Ready to receive him and give him his last trip to Sega, as we go and lay him to rest until we meet again. So I celebrate him as a friend. I thank God for his life. And he shall forever be in my heart. And I think I'll do a song for him, just to celebrate his life.
Maybe one thing that you remember fondly, be between the two of you being friends, that one memory that you have together for Fred, I mean with Fred.
There's a day we went to a club. This club, it was so expensive. It was the first time we went to your club. It was very, very expensive. So tipo ingia kasema unajua wewe ni bazu. So hapa lazima uko hoe. So in that process, another friend came and joined us. And this friend is a young guy but a tycoon. So huyo jamaa alipokuja kuniona akasema, "Guy, what if he is here? I'm your biggest fan. So all the bills today ni mimi nalipa." Ah! Nilipumua. Nikasema bas, because ile club, ile bill ilikuwa pale. Even maji tu unaongea maybe 2000 kuendelea, unajua. So I felt like today Fredia ni set, lakini Mungu akaniokole. So it was just a day we live to remember. We took photos with my wife. And we celebrated that day, we had fun. Yeah. Na hiyo siku I think tulienda clubs kama kumi, if I'm not wrong. Tunaingia tu tukionja, nambia bazule unakuonyesha tuzi maklub. Tuenda tukitoka, until vile tulichoka, tuka separate, kila mtu akaenda zake. And so that day is a day I'll live to remember.
Yeah.
Yeah, kabisa kabisa, because that's the day aliniambia paka life story yake, zile vitu amewahi pitia in life. You know, wale watu wamewahi kosana nao na ni mabeshte, unajua?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the one thing I learned from him that night ya kwamba, ni mtu amekosana na watu lakini aweki kwa roho yake. Anakuja anachana nao, ana forget and they remain to be friends.
Mm.
Yeah, so that's the day I remember.
Okay. Yeah, can you describe Fred as a person?
Fred, number one, alikuwa very simple. As much as alikuwa celebrity, alikuwa very simple. And then akuwa ana live a lie. Unajua ma celebrity wengi wana live a lie. Ya kwamba this is who I am, you know, ile fake it until you make it, unajua. Yeye alikuwa the way he is of Fred.
Yeah.
That is who he used to be. Ana mambo ya kufake vitu ati yo, you know, ma celebrity na ndesha gari kubwa na ishi fancy life. No. He was so simple and he just loved being him.
Yeah.
Real, true and honest.
Yeah.
That's how I can describe it. Real, true and honest.
Yeah.
Maybe one thing that you can tell Eric Omondi, who is now left alone as the only brother. He had Fred as the only brother left, and right now Fred is also gone. Maybe a word of encouragement or something you can tell Eric and the family.
First of all, Eric being someone that knows God, because any mtu tumeomba naye church moja Kisumu, tukiwa vijana, tumekuwa naye shule Kisumu Boys, tulikuwa CU sisi wote. And being someone that knows God, the only encouragement I can give him right now is let him, you know, cling on God, let him focus on Christ. That is the only fortress, that is the only hope he has in life. These things happen, hii dunia sisi wote ni wageni, but akuwe too strong. Let him take charge as now the head of the family, you know. And we are here to pray with him, here to give him moral support and stand with him. And I know, being the person that he's a very courageous guy and a very strong guy. Eric will make it. He will go through this at a time.
Maybe one question. You as a close friend to Fred, do you have a question concerning the death of Fred?
No. At first, tulipokuwa mog, we had doubts. That is the truth. Because the nature of ile tulimpata vile amekaa, the teeth zimeangalia juu and all the stuff, we had doubts. But we took time to investigate ourselves without the police. The only thing the police did was to take us where the motorbike was, where the bus was, and we found the conductor and the driver of the bus. They explained to us everything. So we went at the scene of the accident, we went at the police station, and after investigating thoroughly, we were with YY, the comedian, with Eric Omondi himself, and a few other people. After we did what we did, we were convinced it was an accident. The only question that we have is the rider of the bike went missing. He disappeared in thin air. We've never seen him up to date, and we've not found answers. So that is where we have question marks. Where is he, you know? We'd want to know and get his testimony. Yeah, tujaipata testimony yake. But on the little that we did, the investigation that we did, we are convinced it was an accident. Only that the rider is missing. It's nowhere to be seen.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Engineer Wood Phoebe.
Thank you.
That is Le Grand Engineer Wood Phoebe talking to us there before the body of the late is brought. As you can see, the hearse is now heading to the runway to get the body so that the body can head straight to their home in Sega. This is the hearse that is taking Fred Omondi's body home, and as you can see, the preparation is on. A lot has been happening. We have been waiting here, and finally Fred Omondi's body has touched down Kisumu International Airport and is ready to be taken home. We will be giving you all these live updates as we keep showing you everything that is happening here. So please keep in touch. As you can see there, that is now the body of the late Fred Omondi about to be brought here. As you can see, it is being towed here As you can see, it is being brought here. Guys, it is a very, very painful evening. A very, very painful evening. We are receiving the body of Fred Omondi. Fred Omondi is the younger brother of Eric Omondi, who is one of the biggest comedians Kenya ever had. And as you can see, I'll just try to zoom it so that we can see. The tractor there is bringing the body. And the hearse is also going to pick the body. So we shall be waiting from this end. We shall be waiting from this end to give you all the live updates. And as you can see, all right. So, as you can see, the body has already been brought there and is about to be towed to the hearse. The hearse is already going on the runway to pick the body. We shall be showing you, we shall be giving you all the live updates, because we value as our followers, and we will always give you all the news and updates from the ground as usual. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, we are live from Kisumu International Airport. Kisumu International Airport, this is where the body of the touched down this evening. Few minutes ago, the body just touched down. As you can see, this is the hearse that is going to pick the body. And the hearse is going to pick the body, and we are waiting so that we can show you the procession of the body leaving here to home in Sega. And we shall be taking you through each and every step. As you can see now, this is the hearse that is going to pick up the body of Fred Rick Odhiambo Omondi. A very, very painful and emotional evening. And this is the last flight that Fred Omondi has had, this time as a cargo and not as a passenger. One of the most painful moments that the family of Omondis are having. And as you can see, in a few minutes, we shall be. So, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see now, this is the hearse that is about to take Fred Omondi's body home. And as I told you earlier, this is the last flight that Fred Omondi has had, and it is unfortunate that a day to his demise, Fred Omondi left this very airport as a passenger, and today Fred has touched down as a cargo. And as you can see, it is a very emotional and painful evening to the family, friends and relatives of Fred and Eric Omondi. Yeah, thank you so much. So as you can see, everybody who is watching, we are still live from Kisumu International Airport. Kisumu International Airport, this is where the body of Fred Omondi is being received before a procession is made to their home in Sega, Ugunja. That is in Ugenya. So we shall be bringing you live updates from wherever you are to show you the whole journey from this particular airport. As you can see now in our live images, the body is being towed and is ready to be loaded on the hearse, so that the procession can kick off to their home. Earlier on, the plane was supposed to touch down actually earlier around 6:30, but there has been a lot of delays from Nairobi that made the body to touch down almost an hour later, and that's why up to now the body has not left this very airport to their home. And it is something that so many people have been waiting for. As you can see, earlier on we showed you live images of so many people who are waiting to see Fred Omondi's body. Now the body is being put in the hearse. A very painful moment, ladies and gentlemen. Very, very painful. The body of Fred Omondi has been up. The body of Fred Omondi has been loaded in the hearse and is ready now to leave for their home. One of the most painful evenings we are having and experiencing in this city. And to the family of Fred and Eric Omondi, it is one emotional evening that we can actually feel. The surrounding, the environment is cool, the environment is chilled, and everybody feels so emotional for the loss of this young, vibrant comedian who made us happy, who entertained us, and did his best at his time. So at the airport, we can see a lot of people, a lot of dignitaries, friends to the family of Fred and Eric. We can see Langata MP Honorable Felix Odiwuor Jalango as part of the recipients of this body. Earlier on, some 1 week later, during the celebration of Fred Omondi's life, Jalango said that Fred Omondi was his wingman, that man who was always there for him whenever he wanted him, to accompany him to events. And he has accompanied Fred Omondi on his last flight and on his last departure from home, from the airport to their home. As you can see now, the body has been loaded and is leaving the airport. That is the hearse there. That is the hearse there. And it is coming. This is the hearse that is carrying the body of the late Fred Omondi. Fred Omondi. Now this is the body of Fred Omondi. This is the body of Fred Omondi leaving for home. And as you can see, this is the hearse carrying the body of Fred Omondi. Remember, Fred has just touched. This is the hearse. The body of Fred is here, ladies and gentlemen. A very, very painful evening. A very, very painful evening, ladies and gentlemen. And the body has left, is leaving the airport right now, and it's coming here.
Oh,
I think it's coming here for a brief viewing.
Okay,
so that it can be left to head home officially. As you can see now, that is the hearse carrying the body of Fred Omondi. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a very, very painful evening. A very, very emotional evening.
Sorry.
I don't know where he is. Derek. Eremavi. Hey. Eremavi. Shegiri guy. Bedrit garino nego bedeka a. Ine no regi bedeng e. Ko wo. Then what they call it for bedem bedeng then wagine. So all right, so guys, this is now the hearse that is carrying Fred Omondi, as you can see there. I think we will be having a short viewing of the body. This is the hearse part that is carrying Fred Omondi and is now about to be taken out for a brief viewing. Yes. Yeah. Yes. So the body of Fred Omondi is being.
Yeah, all right. Let's do this. We want to do something small here. See if you don't mind. Ngoja left pange vizuri vile tutafanya. See you.
All right. The one talking is Big Ted, ladies and gentlemen. Big Ted is one of the guys. Yeah. There is the body of Fred Omondi, and as you can see, we also have Langata MP Honorable Felix Jalango, who accompanied the body and is here to receive the body at the airport.
Okay, so that we have order, Abba Penjoni, everybody just moves one step behind. So that we have a good, decent order. All right? And then we'll just wait a few minutes while we just take care of something.
Inside your parking, eh?
All right, so let's just step back, just one. Okay. Let's just create some enough space.
Truly. Oh.
I'm also Ujo Turua. I'm also Ujo Turua. Okwe.
Okwe.
Wase chopuka. To wakwayo ni wa coordinate mondo wadhi maber. The desire is for those in Kisumu to view Freddy before we travel. As we wait for Eric to come, I'd like us to have some order. We would like to pray and then have maybe a possibility of a viewing. Then after that, we will see a way forward. But for now, I'd like to ask Pastor Kolo, if you're around,
Sir Felix.
Caller.
Caller, yes.
Before he speaks, I know it's you're emotional. I'd like the KPC team to sing one song kindly as we wait for the pastor to give us a prayer and maybe a word from the scriptures.
Wana u sehemu yangu, rafiki yangu wewe, katika safari yangu tatembea na wewe, pamoja na wewe, pamoja na wewe, katika safari yangu tatembea na wewe. Mali hapa sikutaka ili niheshimiwe, na yanikute mashaka sawa sawa na wewe, pamoja na wewe, pamoja na wewe, heri nikute mashaka sawa sawa na wewe. Niongoze safarini mbele uwe mlangoni mwa mbinguni, niingie na wewe, pamoja na wewe, pamoja na wewe, mlangoni mwa mbinguni, niingie na wewe, pamoja na wewe, pamoja, pamoja na wewe, mlangoni mwa mbinguni, niingie na wewe.
Let us pray. Everlasting Father, we come before you, Lord, thanking you, Lord, for the life our brother lived, O God. For the many lives that he impacted, the lives that he touched, Lord, we pray that, Lord God, as we grieve, we'll grieve with hope, O God, knowing that a time will come when the dead in Christ will rise again. So, Lord, we thank you for the journey mercies you've granted us, Lord God, from Nairobi all the way to Kisumu. And, Lord God, even from here as we head to Seda, we are praying for your presence to be with us. Lord, we thank you even for those who are still on the way. May you grant them journey mercies. Honor you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let me read a scripture. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 11, 25 and 26, the Bible says, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes, and whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe in this? One thing we believe in is that there is a resurrection of the dead. And those who are in Christ, we shall one day, one time be reunited together with him. And we will celebrate that which we sacrificed here on earth for the sake of God. So I kindly request Pastor June to pray with us and pray for the journey. Then we can do the viewing.
Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We bless you. We honor you, Jehovah, for who you are. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your loving kindness and your mercies that are new every morning. We thank you that, Jehovah, Lord Jesus, we trusted in you, Abba Father, when we left Nairobi this morning. And we ask of you, Father, for safety, Abba Father, for all who are traveling, Abba Father, even as they arrived in Kisumu. And Lord, as we head to Sega, mighty Redeemer, we ask for your presence, King of all glory. Holy One of Israel, we know, my Father, that no one who calls on your name, my God, has ever been put to shame. And so, King of all kings, we are calling on your name, Abba Father. Holy One of Israel, we pray, my Father, that amidst, Abba Father, the pain, oh God, and the turmoil, Abba Father, of Fred's death, Abba Father, we pray that your comfort, Abba Father, shall be upon us, oh God. We pray that, Father, Lord Jesus, you will wipe away our tears, oh God. We pray that on the days and nights, Abba Father, when all of us question, Abba Father, that King of all glory, how did all this happen, Jehovah? That, Lord, we will find comfort in you, King of all kings. Precious Savior, we pray, Abba Father, even for Eric, Abba Father, and Irene, oh God. We pray that, Jehovah, Lord Jesus, you will comfort their hearts, oh God. Precious Savior, we call on your name because you're the one who comforts, Abba Father. Mighty Redeemer, you have said that the peace you give unto us is not like the one the world gives. And so, Lord, we speak your peace over them and the entire family, oh God. We are praying, Father, for the journey to Sega, my God. King of all kings, we ask you to come and take charge, Abba Father. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, that the King of glory may come in. And so, King of glory, we invite you. We invite you to come and walk with us and go with us, oh Lord, to Sega. When we arrive in Sega, safely we'll be careful to say thank you. We pray, my Father, that the airwaves will bow to your name, oh God. We pray even for the weather, O King of all glory, that Jehovah, Lord Jesus, will give us a good weather, O King of all kings. So, Lord, we exalt you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
So, Eric is here. The desire is for us to view for a very few minutes, and then after that we'll see way forward. So people that will help us, if we can line up,
just line up on that side. Then
so no photography.
Don't take photos of them.
I'll do the lighting. No photography.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kindly, just for his.
So keep your phones away. Only a few phones will be here to light the body. Everybody else, kindly, when you come, don't come with your phone.
Okay. So can we have some order? Can we all go on that side so that we file out on this side? All those who want to view, let's have hapa tuwe nyuma huko tafadhali. All right, all of us want to view Tafadana. All right, all of us want to view on that side.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, Derek. So, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see now, the viewing has started and people in Kisumu are now viewing the body, and we are going to... Now, that is Fred Omondi leaving the site. I think he is so emotional, and as you can see, right now, the viewing is on. And we are going to a bit keep it off just to show respect to the dead, that is Fred. We are going to show it from a distance so that we can show you everything, including the procession, as we leave this particular place to Sega. So as you watch, as you keep tuned. Yeah, as you can see now, the viewing is on, and immediately the viewing is done, we are going to leave to Sega, and we are going to show you every movement, the position, and the movement until we get to the place. Tomorrow we will give you a full coverage of the burial, and we advise you to keep tuned, because this is where you will get all the news, all the live images, and all the coverages tomorrow and tonight, until we get to bury our beloved brother Fred Omondi. So from wherever you are watching, this is SK Media Simi Kenya and SK Media Facebook fan page. On YouTube, we are Simi Kenya TV. So keep tuning in so that we can give you all the exclusives, all the live images of this particular event. So right now the mood is so emotional. People are so emotional. It is very, very emotional. As you see, the viewing is going on right now, and it is very, very emotional. So, from wherever you are, let me take. Very good. Okay. Keep talking.
videos mema kwa kada mana chako post ni
ona nini ape nje waenda waenda
podi
okwenda okwenda ndio naona ona
sasa
mimi mwenda kwa
kwa nini noka kai bidunga macha sawa kama kuenda
Girwacha de baby, man kama college.
Ni wewe guna.
Gani? Ako kwa gani?
Thank you.
Thank you. kuja mejingiza si alikuwa mbele
niko nimejiga
lakini hili yembe design maana ya
passport card ni nini passport
card hawa jojo mate yeye ndio mtingo hili ngo yelo tunajua.
nyono te bana to the bed.
It is hot. It's hot.
Thank you.
Lori Jaba.
I love you, Jamas.
Ni moroke.
Mas, ni gari kani kita.
Tangu mundu njepa.
Ntie gari, ano kadua golo ngatenda raba. Unaona yo kutuwa mtu inje ni mbae. Sasa wana hiyo.
Ish, ona, 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 ona,
bana ba. Oh, invite rangwech bana. Eh. Eh, sa abira abira. Sa sa abira. pani koth na mummy opre to slippery.
Shiko.
Tunaona kiasi na tushtua
ukimu. Tegi, wacha kutukimbia.